thank you so much for your sacrifice, John, giving up that bow tie for our community.
I love that bow tie.
I know, but trust me, it's gone on to a good place to do amazing work for the community. Thanks so much, John. We have Christine Madras here. She is with the St. Charles County Parks and Recreation Department. She's going to show us how to turn gourds into birdhouses. You can learn how to do the same thing, too, so that the birds aren't trying to come in your house. You make them their own house. And then they'll be fine. So what is the first thing that we're going to do when we get to the event? And also, it's going to be at the historic Daniel Boone home. You guys will already have the gourds there. What's the first thing you're going to do?
So the first thing that guests do when they've already pre-registered, mm-hmm. will have numerous amounts of gourds ready for them to pick from.
Yeah.
For example, they will look like this, only a little bit wetter.
Because
they'll be soaking. So each guest gets to pick one of these gourds out.
Uh-huh.
And then they will start the process of cleaning the sides of the gourd.
Okay, all right, cool. So you walk them through cleaning mm-hmm. the sides of the gourd mm-hmm. so that they come out looking nice and smooth.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, they'll use a little copper scrub to get the skin off of the gourd there. And then when that is finished, mm-hmm. It will look like this.
All right.
So you can kind of see the difference.
I'll go ahead and hold on to this one.
Okay.
It feels a little scary. Yours looks a little nicer.
So this one is one that has been already polished and mm-hmm. cleaned. So it is ready to start the process of creating the holes. This one is more meant for a wren, a type of bird. So this is about the size of the hole that you want for a wren.
Very, very, very small bird.
Yes, very small bird. But you can make these holes bigger for larger style birds, like bluebirds, different birds like that. So we use just a little saw. Handsaw.
Okay. And would you guys be doing this, or would you be walking the class members through this?
So we will be using this.
Okay.
We will be using the saw just for.
Okay.
Because it's a knife.
Or because it's a knife. And the youngest students, how
yes.
old can they be?
Eight and up. Yes,
okay.
Eight and up is what we would like to do. So I already started that hole because mm-hmm. it takes a little while to really get through the skin,
right.
The hard shell of the gourd. And then we will have a drill where mm-hmm. you can make holes in the bottom. This is actually for to let air into the gourd mm-hmm. and to let water out if it's raining. And then you make little holes in the sides here for the wiring.
Oh, the wiring like this one right here.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
All right, so you can go ahead, hang it from a tree mm-hmm. or the side of your house or whatever. Okay,
exactly.
pretty cool. How do we make the beautiful colors here?
So this coloring mm-hmm. on this is actually one that one of our talented volunteers did for us. She started painting the design that you see here, and then she did shoe polish on top of that.
Wow, pretty cool, mm-hmm. pretty cool. All right, everybody, this is all waiting for you this weekend, November 11th, from 11 to 3 at the historic Daniel Boone home. It's called Gourd Crafting, Painting and Birdhouses, 1868 Highway F in Defiance. Just call 636-949-7535, stccparks.org. And also, when you get there, you'll learn not only about these birdhouses, but about the history of these ladles right here. It's all about repurposing and making sure everyone has a home this winter here on the 9 a.m. show.